Honored guests, ladies and gentlemen, the African Development Bank and the International Fund for Agriculture Development, IFAD, and their partners deserve our commendations for hosting this very important dialogue on perhaps the most crucial development issue today, food security, and focusing especially on financing and partnerships that would promote Africa's agricultural transformation through technology and innovation. Nigeria has prioritized investment in specific innovations and technologies to achieve on scale or at scale transformation of its agriculture. And I'll very quickly mention three initiatives that we are currently either implementing or working on that speak directly to these issues. At the heart of Nigeria's post-COVID-19 recovery plan, or what we describe as our economic sustainability plan, is an agriculture for food and jobs plan, where we seek to leverage suitable technologies to build a resilient food system for Nigeria, especially in the light of the economic, health, and food supply chain devastations caused by the pandemic. Implementation is well underway, and we have quite a few impressive results already. During the COVID lockdowns, we trained and deployed over 34,000 graduates, young graduates, all over the country, covering over 8,000 local wards in 774 local government areas. Each of these young men and women had a locally developed app on smartphones and an electronic tablet to digitally register farmers and map out their farm GIS coordinates. So we've registered and mapped out about 6 million smallholder farmers to their farmlands. And we're also currently collecting 200,000 composite soil samples from these farms to be analyzed in 22 local soil laboratories to guide local fertilizer blending. On the back of the farmer farm database which we've developed, we're developing a digital agriculture exchange program, Ag Exchange, working with the Alliance Rabobank and MasterCard in collaboration with some local fintech companies. Now, these fintech companies are run by young men and women. We have Farm Crowdy, Infinera, and Crop IT. The Agriculture Exchange will be an ecosystem or a one-stop shop for providing a range of services and products to smallholder farmers, such as real-time e-subsidies, Credit Connect by providing credit score of farmers on the platform and linking them to financiers, insurance services, marketplace services for connecting producers, aggregators, and off-takers based on competitive market prices. Input suppliers also, weather, pests and diseases, indexing services will be provided on the exchange as well. The budget for the Agriculture for Foods and Jobs Plan is in the order of about $1.5 billion. The second initiative is our Livestock Transformation Plan. Now, this is a 10-year plan to transform the livestock subsector, with the focus being on transiting gradually from the nomadic system of cattle production to the more sedentary methods of ranching. This will involve training pastoralists in new ways of producing and rearing cattle sustainably to address the challenges of resource-based violent conflicts between crop farmers and cattle herders, and the generally low milk and beef productivity of indigenous cattle breeds. So the plan is to train the pastoralists in husbandry methods, emphasizing sustainable and climate-smart ranching. An indigenous technology company has developed a microchip for tracking the cattle, and we're working on a pilot project with one of our development partners, the Netherlands government, all the energy on the ranches will be from biogas, from cattle dung and solar power. The ranch will have an integration of crops, pasture, and trees. The crops for the need of the pastoral household, the trees to fight desertification and enhance carbon sequestration rather than emission. So funding for this is from the budgets of federal and state governments. And of course, as I've mentioned, bilateral support from development partners such as the government of the Netherlands. The initial sum is in the order of about $280 million US dollars. The third is what we describe as a green imperative project. Now, this is a five-year project, and it's in the sum of about 995 million euros, funded by the Import and Export Bank of Brazil, with support from the Jewish Bank, the Islamic Development Bank, and a few others. It's an agriculture technology transfer package from Brazilian original equipment manufacturers, research and training institutes, to Nigeria's entrepreneurs, research institutes, and businesses. The project involves the reactivation of dormant or partially operational privately owned agricultural equipment assembly plants. And we also plan to establish under the program 632 privately owned primary production support service centers to sell farm mechanization services to smallholder and commercial farmers to address low productivity issues. Part of the plan also is the establishment of about 142 privately owned agro-processing service centers, which will also be established to address post-harvest losses, path to market and supply chain challenges, and train about 100,000 new extension agents to address farmer advisory service delivery challenges with new technology and practice adoption. An important feature of our strategy, as I close, is encouraging our young techpreneurs into agriculture and agro-services. And we're enjoying some success, as I said earlier, with the technology for our agro-exchange. And our central bank is also licensing fintech companies on using mobile technology platforms. Some of them have been able to give non-collateral credit using credit scoring algorithms to determine credit worthiness of farmers. And this is a very important part of our whole financial inclusion project, because these fintech companies are able to reach farmers practically anywhere, rate them, you know, using their credit scoring algorithms, and get credit across to them in many of these far-flung areas. And so I agree with Dr. Adishin, and I believe Mr. Tony Blair, that the future must involve making agriculture cool to attract young people. Thank you very much for your time and attention.